Okay, so morning everyone. See, in the last class, we were discussing about how to build or construct a rule-based classifier. So in that, I explained that see, in case of rule-based classifier, we will be having a set of rules. These set of rules will be identifying the relationship that is going to exist between the attributes of the data set and the class level. Okay, so in order to extract such rules, we have got two methods here. So first method is using direct method, where directly from the given data set or the data, we will be extracting the rules, classification rules. That is direct method. And second one is indirect method, where we will be extracting the rules from other classification models like decision tree induction algorithms, or even we can use the neural networks. Okay, so for extracting the classification rules. So in the last class, we have studied about one of the method that is for extracting or building a rule-based classifier, that is using direct method. So in that, we have used a sequential covering algorithm. So this algorithm we have discussed in the last class. Okay, so apart from that, see, we have seen see how this learn one rule function is going to work in case of rule-based classifier in order to extract or in order to generate one rule at a time. Okay, so till this we have discussed. Now coming to how we can grow the rules in the rule-based classifier. Okay, so that is how we can add or how we can improve the rules which are present in a rule-based classifier. See, there are two strategies which we can use in order to grow or increase the rules which are present in a rule-based classifier. So one is general to specific method or a strategy, and second one is specific to general. So using these two methods, we can include the rules, or we can grow the rules, okay, which are required for rule-based classifier. So coming to the first one, that is the general to specific. So in case of general to specific, initially we'll be having an empty rule here, okay, that is also called as a default rule. See, in each of the step, we will be improving this rule by adding one conjunct. Okay, so on the LHS part. Okay, so each time we will be adding one conjunct on the LHS part. Okay, so in order to improve the quality of the rule here. So in first one is general to specific. See, in case of general to specific, we'll be having the general rule here. So general rule, as you know, it will be a default rule. So in case of default rule, say rule antecedent will be empty. Okay, and on the LHS part, we'll be having a default class level, that is Y. Okay, so that is the default class level. So what we will be doing is, see, each time we will be adding new conjunct. So conjunct is nothing but that is the attribute value pairs here. See, on the LHS part, so in order to improve the rules quality. Okay, but the thing is, see, this general to specific that is strategy, see, it will be not having a good quality rules, because initially it will be having a general rule here, that is a default. Okay, so since it is going to cover all the rules, sorry, all the examples, so what we need to do is, each time in order to improve the rules quality, we need to add a conjunct on the LHS side. Okay, so I will explain you the example. So see here, see, this is one of the example where we have applied the general to specific strategy in order to increase or improve the rule quality here. Initially, we have got the empty antecedent here. Okay, so any none of the that is attribute values pairs are present in the LHS part. And on the RHS, see, this is for the vertebrate classification problem. That is, see, the rule that we want to define is for the mammals class. Okay, so in case of general to specific, so we don't have any of the that is conjuncts on the LHS side. So at each step, we will be improving the rule quality here. Okay, so in the next step, see here, we have added one of the conjunct, that is body temperature is equal to warm-blooded. So that is going to define mammals. And also skin cover is equal to hair, we have added, that is going to define the mammals. And then has legs is equal to no. Okay, so that is also going to define the mammals. Okay, so like this, see, we will be increasing the rule quality by adding more conjuncts in the subsequent steps. Okay, so next step, if you observe here, so again we have added that is two more conjuncts here. That is, initially we had one conjunct, that is body temperature is equal to warm-blooded, and then we have added one more, that is Hazlex is equal to S, then that is going to define mammals, and then body temperature is equal to warm blooded and gives birth is equal to S, that is also going to define mammals. So like this, in each step we will be adding one conjunct, okay, so we will be able to, that is, cover all the training examples here. Okay, so like this we will be increasing the rule. Okay, so once we meet the stopping condition, that is once we add all the conjuncts on the LHS side, okay, then at that time we will be stopping the rule growing process here. So initially we had empty antecedent. Okay, so here our main aim is we want to define the rule for the mammals, for assigning the class labels to mammals. So initially we have got empty antecedent here. So at each step we will be adding the conjuncts here. So in the next step, what we have done is, see, we have added, okay, so we have added one more conjunct, body temperature is equal to warm blooded. Okay, so like this, next we have added one more, that is conjunct, that is has like is equal to yes, that is also going to define the mammals here. Okay, so like this we will be growing the rules here in each of the steps. Okay, so now coming to the second one, that is specific to general. Okay, so in case of specific to general strategy, so initially we will be having one positive example that is going to cover all the training examples. So initially we'll be having all the training examples, we will be having one rule that will be defining or that will be covering all the positive examples here. So during rule refinement, we will remove one of the conjunct in each of the step here. So see here, it is exact opposite of, that is, general to specific. So in case of specific to general, see, initially we have got the one positive example. So this positive example, it will be covering all the rules here. Okay, so it will be covering all the rules. So in each of the step, subsequent step, we will be removing one conjunct. Okay, so if you observe here, so in this, see, we have removed one of the conjunct. Okay, so once we remove that conjunct, we will be getting a more more general kind of a rule that is going to cover some more examples here. Okay, so if you observe here, see, we have removed hibernate is equal to no. So in this rule here, okay, so initially we had hibernate is equal to no in this rule, but here, see, we have removed it. See, hibernate is equal to no, that conjunct is not present here. Okay, so this is specific to general. See, in case of general to specific, we will be having empty antecedent. At each step we will be adding the rule conjuncts here in order to grow the rules. Okay, and in case of specific to general, okay, so in case of specific to general, see, we will be having the one positive example. That positive example will be covering all the training records. So in each subsequent step, we'll be removing one conjunct from this example. Okay, so if you observe here, so this positive example, see, it will be covering all the training records. So in the next subsequent step, see, we have removed this hibernate is equal to no. Okay, so once we remove that, we'll get more general rule here. So this is the general rule. Okay, so this is the difference here. Okay, so either we can go with the general to specific strategy or specific to general strategy, but we must define the rules in such a way that, see, they must be able to cover all the training examples which are present in the training set. Okay, so this is about the two strategies. Okay, now coming to the next thing, that is for the indirect method that we can use for the rule extraction. See, we had studied about the direct method, say, where we have discussed about the sequential covering algorithm. See, in case of direct method, see, directly from the given data we'll be extracting the rules. Okay, in case of indirect method, see, for the rule extraction, we will be using some different classification models like decision tree and the neural networks. In case of direct method, see, we don't use any other classification models for generating the rules here. Instead of that, directly from the given data we will generate the rules. But in case of indirect method, see, we will take the example of the other classification models like decision trees and the neural networks. Okay, so if you look at the example here, okay, so we have got one of the example. So where we have generated the rules from the decision tree. Okay, see how we have generated the rules here. Okay, so we have got a decision tree here. So for each of the path from the root node to the leaf node, see for this decision tree, we will be defining the classification rule here. So classification rule, so that will be defined for every path, that is from the root to the leaf node. So if you observe here, see from for this path, we have defined one root, that is P is equal to no and Q is equal to no. So that is going to define the class level minus. So see here, this is the first rule that we have generated, that is P is equal to no and Q is equal to no. So that is going to define the class level, that is minus. So in the same way, P is equal to no and then Q is equal to yes, that is going to define positive class. And then P is equal to yes and then R is equal to no, that is positive class. And then P is equal to yes, R is equal to yes, and then Q is equal to no, so that is going to define the negative class. And then P is equal to yes, R is equal to yes, and then Q is equal to yes, that is going to define a positive class. So like this, see for every path that is present in the decision tree, we will be defining a rule here. Okay, so if you observe here in the rule, so this rule antecedent, so it will be containing the test conditions here. So these are the test conditions which are present in the decision tree. Okay, so test conditions are nothing but that is P is equal to no and then Q is equal to no. Those are the test conditions here. So those test conditions, see, they are present on the LHS part, that is in the rule antecedent. And coming to the RHS part, see, this RHS part will be containing a class label here. So class label is nothing but the leaf node. Okay, that is considered as a rule consequent. So rule antecedent will be containing the, that is test conditions here. So test conditions are nothing but attribute value pairs, that is P is equal to no, Q is equal to no, and then P is equal to no, Q is equal to yes. See, all these are test conditions that will present in rule antecedent. Now coming to the rule consequent, see, this rule consequent will be containing a class label here. So class label will be present at the leaf node. So like this, see, in case of the indirect method, so we'll be generating the rules with the help of a decision tree here. So we'll not take the help of data. Okay, so after generating the decision tree, from that decision tree we will be finding the rules here, that is a rule based classifier. Okay, so now coming to one more thing is, see, even we can improve some of the rules here. Okay, so if you observe here, see, that is R2, R3 and then R5. Okay, so if you consider the positive that is rules R2, R3 and R5, that is P is equal to no and Q is equal to yes, that is positive. P is equal to yes and then Q is equal to no, that is positive. And then P is equal to yes, R is equal to yes, Q is equal to yes, that is positive. That is R2, R3, R5 rules. So in this, see, whenever Q is equal to yes is present, then the class label is positive. Okay, so by looking at this, some of the assumption, so what we can do is, see, we can improve the quality of the rules by simplifying the rules here. So if you want to improve the quality of the rules that we have generated using rule based classifier, even we can simplify that. If you simplify that, then those simplified rules, they are going to improve the quality here. So in order to simplify that, see here, we will redefine this second rule as R2 dash. So here we have defined the R2 dash as Q, whenever Q is equal to S is present, then it will be considered as positive. And we will remove this Q is equal to yes from R3. So it is not present here. Okay, so R3 will be defined as P is equal to yes and R is equal to no. So like this, we have redefined the rules here in order to improve the quality. Okay, so initially we had some of the rules here. See, whenever we observe the rules, that is R2 and then R5, whenever Q is equal to yes is present, then that is going to define positive class label. Okay, so in order to predict the class label as positive, so this Q is equal to yes can be used here. So we have simplified this R2 as Q is equal to yes, so it is defined as positive class. Okay, and then R3 is kept as it is because this Q is equal to yes is not present there. Okay, so even see for R5, okay, so we can just place, that is P is equal to yes and R is equal to yes, that is sufficient to define R5. So like that, we can simplify the rules here which are present in the rule based classifier. Okay, so now coming to which is the algorithm that is present for defining the rules in case of indirect method. So in case of direct method, we had a sequential covering algorithm. So with the help of sequential covering algorithm, we had generated the rules. Now in case of indirect method, we have got one of the algorithm, that is C4.5 rules algorithm. So this C4.5 rules algorithm, so it can be used to generate the rules in case of rule-based classifier. Okay. So see here, in case of this C4.5, see again, same procedure we will be following, that is from root to the leaf node, we will be finding the rules here. So if you see here, okay, so we have defined many rules here, that is for this given vertebrate classification problem. Okay, so we have got a tree here. Using this decision tree, we have defined the different rules here. Okay, so now if you look here, so that is gives birth is equal to no, okay, and then aquatic creature is equal to yes, that has been defined as species. Okay, so that we have generated, and then gives birth is equal to no, and then aquatic creature is equal to semi, it is going to define the amphibians. Okay, and then gives birth is equal to no, aquatic creature is equal to no, and then aerial creature is equal to yes, that is going to define birds. Okay, and then gives birth is equal to no, aquatic creature is equal to no, and then aerial creature is equal to no, then it is reptiles. So like that we have defined the rules. Okay, so for this vertebrate classification problem. Okay, so in general, see what we have done here is, see for every path from the root to the leaf node, we have defined a rule here. Okay, so for example, see if we consider the rule in this form, that is see here R colon A employs Y. Okay, so then that rule, so even it can be simplified as R dash colon A dash employs Y. Okay, so we can simplify that rule. Okay, so the simplification will be done by removing some of the conjuncts which are present in the that is rule based classifier. Okay, so initially we will be having some of the rules here. So in order to improve the quality of the rules, so we'll be removing some of the conjuncts from this rules which we have defined. Okay, so like this, see, we can improve the quality of the rules. Okay, so that is, see, what we have done is, see, in order to improve the quality of the rules, see, we have considered those rules which have got the less error rate. So we need to add only those rules which have got the less error rates, so that we will be able to classify all the records. Okay, and also sometimes, see, if there are any of the duplicate that is rules, if they are present, that also must also be removed here. So initially we'll be having a complete set of rules, just like in case of that is specific to general strategy. Okay, so initially we'll be having complete set of rules. Okay, that those set of rules will be covering all the training records. So we'll be simplifying that rules as R dash. So R is the set of rules. Okay, R dash will be simplified set of rules. So now in order to remove the rules from this given set R, so we'll be considering those rules which have got the low error rate. So only those rules which have got the low error rate will be kept in the rule set, and the other rules, and also those other rules which are duplicate, they will also be removed. So like this, we will be using the C4.5 rules algorithm in order to generate the rules in the rule-based, indirect method for rule-based classifier. Okay. And one more thing is about the rule ordering here. See here, if you observe, see, we have followed the class-based ordering scheme. Okay, so that is one of the method that will be used for ordering the rules. So we have used the class-based ordering scheme. So here, in case of class-based ordering scheme, see, the rules will be ordered which are having the same class level. So all the rules that are having same class levels, they will be appearing together in case of class-based ordering scheme. Okay, so this is one of the algorithm that we'll be using for in case of indirect method for generating the rules. Okay, so now coming to the characteristics of rule-based classifier. Okay, so first characteristics is, see, the expressiveness of this rule-based classifier, it is almost equivalent to the decision tree that is algorithm. Or see, the rules or the method that we will be following here, see, they are going to give you the same results or same performance as to that of decision tree induction algorithm. So both the decision tree induction algorithm and the rule based classifier, they are having the same performance. So this expressiveness of the rule set, see, it is equivalent to the decision tree induction algorithm. So it means that, So it will be having both the mutually exclusive and exhaustive rules property. Okay. And see, one more thing is about the that is rule-based classifier. Okay. So in case of rule-based classifier, say sometimes the multiple rules will be triggered, as you know. See, whenever we don't implement the mutually exclusive property, see, then more than one rule will be triggered by a record. Okay. So such cases can be avoided, as I explained, with the help of by defining the rules in such a way that they are mutually exclusive. Okay, so by defining mutually exclusive rules and exhaustive rules, so we can give the same performance as that of the decision tree induction algorithm. So the expressiveness of the rule set, okay, or rule based classifier, it is same as that of the decision tree induction algorithm. Okay, and see, coming to the second property, okay, so this rule based classifier, it is used to produce the descriptive model. Okay, so ultimately, see, our aim is we want to construct a model here. So the model that is generated with the help of rule-based classifier, okay, that is a descriptive model. So it is very, very easy to interpret. Anyone can easily understand. So what is the problem that has been defined? Okay, and how we can use that for classification tasks. So it is very, very interpretable. Okay. And coming to the third property, see this class-based ordering approach that we have followed in case of rule-based classifier. Okay, so even it can handle the data set that has got the imbalanced data. Okay, so imbalanced data means, see, in that data, see, equal number of records will not be present. That is for the classes. For example, if you have got positive and negative class, then the number of records will not be equal here. Positive class records and the negative class records, they will not be equal. So this class-based ordering scheme, see, it can be very helpful for handling the data set that will be having imbalanced class distribution here. So these are the properties. So first one is about the expressiveness of the rule set here. So this expressiveness of the rule set, okay, so of a decision tree induction algorithm, say it is almost equivalent to decision tree induction algorithm. And second thing is about the, that is a model that we will be generating with the help of rule-based classifier. So this rule-based classifier model, it is very easy to understand. It is very interpret. It is very easy to interpret here. And the third one is about the, that is handling of the data that will be containing imbalanced data class labels. So since we are using the class-based ordering scheme here, so this class-based ordering scheme, it is very, it can easily handle the data that contains the imbalanced class labels here. Okay, so see, this is about the that is indirect method for that is rule extraction. Okay, so next topic, so we shall discuss in the next class. Okay, just wait for some time. Okay, so I'll take your attendance.